ready to match the star, George Kennedy, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Loretta Swit, Richard Dawson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reilly!
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
I haven't seen you. Haven't seen you in ages.
Yeah,
how nice to, you know, she's been off the show so long. She's been in New York doing a marvelous play and all. It's like having a new kid on the block again, isn't it? So we have to welcome her properly.
Brisk
round of applause here while we welcome the new kid on the block. Applause, applause, applause. He said this rascal. He said that's what kept her away last time. She goes.
The only part of the show she hates.
All right. Nice to have you back, George Old Bean.
Hi, thank you, Gene.
How's everything on the blue night there?
Well, you get to kiss Loretta, and I got a dog that tinkles on my leg downtown.
Now let's say hello to the current champ, Deborah Mitchell.
Hello.
How are you? Now, Deborah's won one game. She has $200 to her credit, and we were into the audience match, the first part of it, and she will be playing for $1,000 on that super match, and we'll see if she'll collect that money in a moment or so, but right now, let's see about this. This lady just ready to have a go at it now. She won the $100, means she'll be playing for 10 times that amount, or $1,000. But Deborah, in order to give you the money, you've got to match one celebrity exactly, and you have to choose one now.
Betty.
It's you, Betty. It's you. You are the one, my dear. All right, stand on the tape and face me. You're on the tape. Face this way here. I'll get the one that's worth $1,000, and it reads as follows. Organ blank. Organ, O-R-G-A-N, blank. Now, Deborah. Get your ESP going over to Betty White. You chose her. You must have some affinity for her. Give us the answer she's already written on her card, and we give you the $1,000. Organ blank.
Grinder.
Yeah. Organ grinder. Okay. Betty, she says organ grinder will match it for $1,000. What do you say to that?
Darling, I am so sorry. I looked at the age of this one, and I thought she wouldn't even know. I said organ music. I am so sorry.
You rejected organ grinder because you thought she was too young.
I thought she was too young.
Yes.
I know. I deserve it. Sorry.
It's all right. No, you don't deserve it. You're okay. There are a number of good choices there.
Sorry,
organ grinder, organ music. What else is there?
Well, let's not discuss anything else.
The organ played at twilight. Thank you, John. I'm sorry I asked.
A lot of organ grinder.
Let's press on here, Deborah. You're still a champ. You're going to be another player now. Here comes Fran Hina. So you're Fran Hina.
I am.
It's two words. She made nine syllables out of those two words. Where are you from, Fran?
Originally from Memphis, Tennessee, and I live in Potomac, Maryland now.
Uh-huh.
And I'm married to a Navy dentist.
Yes.
Have a marvelous grown son. And I'm thrilled to be here.
We're thrilled to have you, Fran. I hope you win some money.
Thank you.
Show it again. There it is, Fran. You may have A or B.
I will take A, please.
Okay, Fran. Isn't she a polite lady?
Sweet. I love Southerners.
Polite.
I do.
Eddie Bob said to the Northern, he says, I'll tell you how scarce women are in these here parts. Over in the next holler, Zeke just married his blank. That's how scarce women are.
Where are they?
For heaven's sakes.
Eddie Bob's up in the norther. I'll tell you how scarce women are in these parts. Over in the next holler, Zeke just married his blank.
Where are they? Up in the Kentucky mountains or somewhere?
That's right. That's a big good place. It's a good place.
Just married.
Frame one. I got it.
You can hear it, Fran. Well, I sure am going to repeat it for you 2-3 times.
Thank you.
Eddie Bob said to the northerner, he says, I'll tell you how scarce women are in these here parts. Over in the next holler, Zeke just married his blank. Don't say anything yet. Think about it. I'll tell you how scarce women are in these parts. Over in the next holler, Zeke just married his blank. Ready over there?
Just
okay,
a second.
Charles. Okay, Charles, we're ready. Now okay. We're ready for your answer, Fran. Do you understand the question?
Would you read it one more time?
The idea is, one guy saying to another guy, I'll tell you how scarce women are in these parts. Over in the next holler,
I
that would
that.
Be like in the next valley, Zeke just married his blank.
Zeke just married his dog.
Dog.
I love Gene.
Did you buy a one-way or a round-trip ticket? Just married his dog.
No.
No?
I had him marrying his mule.
Married his mule? Well, the same idea you had, Fran, except it's a different animal. Mule is an animal. Da, 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 da. What do you say?
Oh, give us another call.
No.
She's so cute. I love Southerners. There's something about New Englanders and Southerners. They always get on. I'm sorry I didn't say dog. I said pig. Now it's got four legs.
Right.
Thank you, darling.
Well, there's animals. I really didn't expect all those animals to appear. Charles, what'd you say?
I said Zeke married his brother Clement.
Blam, blam, blam. Well, I'll tell you how scarce women are in these parts. Over the next holler, Zeke just married
His horse.
What do we got, a pig, a horse? What was
yours,
George?
Closer.
A mule. And his
a
brother, Clem.
Talk to the animals.
Okay.
Zeke, I happen to know, did marry his mule. Made an ass out of himself.
Yeah. Two mules so far, Fran. But no dogs.
No, just a darn minute. Maybe it was a Doberman Pinscher.
What do you say?
He married his dog.
Good for you, Fran. So there's your first rounder. Yours will be long later. Right now, we've got this just for you. One. Here we go. Second half of round one. Deborah, your question. Listen carefully. Fred said.
Yeah.
In my neighborhood, if a teenage girl is on the pill, she's called progressive. If she's not, she's called blank. Oh, I got a good one. I'm sorry I'm not playing. Okay. Good.
Charles tried to look at my answer, Uncle
All
Jane.
Right.
Still peeking, huh?
Yes.
Once more, she's what's the...
Oh, Fred said, in my neighborhood, if a teenage girl is on the pill, she's called progressive. If she's not, she's called blank.
Gotta take a shot at that.
All right. We'll scroll over here to Deborah Mitchell.
Cute. I love it.
Ready, Charles? Here we go. Fred said, in my neighborhood, if a teenage girl is on the pill, she's called progressive. If she's not, she's called blank.
Pregnant.
All right. So there it is.
Oh, Deborah, I let you down. I went for the rhyme. I thought of that. I went for the rhyme. Repressive.
She's called progressive. If she's not, she's called repressive. That's fair. You are a poet, aren't you, George? Okay. George, you win some, you lose some. What do you say?
Well, there's many advantages to being over the hill. One of them is you no longer get pregnant.
Right? I want you to know I'll fight any man in this bar who says you're over the hill.
Thank you.
Okay.
I'll fight anybody who says she's pregnant.
What do you say?
I said it rhymes.
It does?
Progressive.
Progressive.
Pregnessive.
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 He made an adjective out of whatever that... What do you say?
I gave her a nickname. I said Preggy.
Preggy, of course. That's sweet for her. Yes, it does count. All right, Richard.
Well, I didn't say pregnant, so would you read the question?
Yes. Fred said, my neighborhood of a teenage girl is on the pill. She's called progressive. If she's not, she's called...
Several times a day. I said with child.
With child. That's another one for her. 4-1 the score. Now, Miss Betty Honey.
Listen, I've got to make it up to Deborah some way. I said pregnant. Just plain and okay. Plain pregnant.
Amazing! It's really tough to do that in a first round question. And now, Fran, again, you have a choice of A or B.
Do you think I might do better if I change to B?
I don't know, honey. You want change?
Yes, I'll change to B.
You can have anything you want. All
right,
you want B, you got B. Don't take it. Long John Periwinkle.
Would you repeat that again?
Yes. Long John Periwinkle, the 102-year-old pirate, is too old to go yo-ho-ho and a bottle of rum. So instead he goes yo-ho-ho and a bottle of blank.
Got it.
That is it.
You lay out this round because you matched her. No,
you can play.
Can I just play with my...
Yes, of course. Naturally, yes.
My card I'm going to
play. All right. Everybody got it up there. Here we go with Franina. Long John Periwinkle, 102-year-old pirate, is too old to go, yo-ho-ho, in a bottle of rum. So instead he goes, in a bottle of...
Geritol.
Okay. All the teenagers in the audience are yaying Geritol. What do you say to that, George?
I couldn't let that accent down for me.
There it is. Make it two for Fran. She's a good kid.
I think I play better when I have pneumonia. Geritol.
Oh, goodness. Charles? Don't cough on Charles. We need him.
Who needs him? Oh, I'm sorry, Steve.
She's a very sick woman.
Geritol. Okay, that's three. Now the score is 5-4 at this moment. Loretta?
Geritol.
Yeah, look at that. Nice score there. You wouldn't let that little lady down, would you?
No, I wouldn't. Would you repeat the question?
Oh, yes.
No, not that question. The question.
Oh, yeah.
Geritol.
Well, now, this is a very unusual and exciting game, as games go, because the score is 6-5. There's one person you have to match. That's George Kennedy.
Oh,
if you do that, you get a tie. If not, then Fran Enoch will have won the game. And here it is. The Bionic Woman said, today the Bionic Man is entered in the Bionic Olympics. So to make him run faster, I'm going to blank his ball bearings.
Got it.
Sure, I'll read it again for you, Deborah.
Right.
Anything you say. All right, I'll read it while he's writing his answer. You know who the Bionic Woman is, don't you? All right. The Bionic Woman said, today the Bionic Man is entered in the Bionic Olympics. So to make him run faster, I'm going to blank his ball bearings.
I got charge.
Charge.
Recharge. You can't.
Recharge his ball bearings. Now, George must say recharge his ball bearings in order for you to achieve a tie here. If he doesn't say recharge his ball bearings, then Fran will have won the game. Okay, George, it's show and tell time.
Does my expression give you a clue? I had grease.
Grease your ball bearings. That's what you did to it. Congratulations, Fran. You won the game. Congratulations. Stand on the tape there. I'm going to back you tomorrow. That's right. Stand right there, honey. Don't make another move, Kelly. Well, Deborah, you're not leaving here empty-handed. I'm very happy about that. And your third-grade school children will be very happy. Aren't they third-grade?
Preschool.
What's that?
Preschool. It's daycare center.
Oh, whatever it is. Your kids will love the fact that you won some money. Deborah
goodbye.
Mitchell. Thank you very much. And while she's spinning off, the spinning message is for you. Now, here we are. Fran has won her first game. She's just got $100, but she could win over $5,000 here. How does that grab you?
Great.
Good. Well, we like that kind of enthusiasm, Fran. Here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank young. Now, the answer they gave most frequently will get you $500 if you match it. Now, if you match their second most popular answer, you get $250, and then the third will get you $100, which ain't bad either. Now, three of our six celebrities are permitted to help here.
Richard, please.
Robert Young.
Robert Young is one.
Betty.
Too Young.
Too Young.
Big Song.
Charles.
That's right, it was a big song. Charles, what do you say? Have you got one?
I wanted to go with Brett's Perfume, Forever Young.
Yes.
But I'm going to go with Loretta Young.
So, now we have Loretta Young, Robert Young, and Too Young. Now, you may either choose one of those or reject all three of them and give us one of your own. What is your pleasure?
I would like Robert Young.
We'll deliver him right away.
Yeah.
I'll bet he's like you.
What
should.
Time do you want him and where do you want him? We'll arrange it for you. Anytime. Okay. Let's see if we got a Robert Young on the premises. May we see the $100 number? Neil Young.
Who's that? I'm sick of those names coming out that I don't know.
You're sick of those names you never heard of, right,
Brett? Who are they?
I don't know who Neil Young is. Who is Neil Young?
Brigham Young's brother.
A big singer.
Oh.
A big pop singer, rock and roll type singer. I'm sorry, Neil Young, I never heard of you, but you know, I mean, nothing personal. We want Robert Young, that's what we want. May we see the $250 Young? Go ahead, Loretta Young is up there. That ain't bad, okay. Last chance for you, Robert Young. Slide it, Earl. Yeah! Great, that's $600 altogether. Isn't that grand? And you're going to play for 10 times that amount of $5,000. And we'll give you the money after you match somebody.
Yes.
Who do you think you got some luck with?
You know I'm going with Richard.
No.
I'm going to go with Fran.
A second ago, she wanted Robert Young. Now she wants you. Women are fickle, aren't they? All right. You ready to stand on the adhesive tape there and face this way? And I'll get the thing that's worth $5,000. Get your ESP going over to Dawson. So far, you're doing great with him. Here it is. Record blank. That's R-E-C-O-R-D. Record blank. Record blank. He took a long time with that, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
Well, I hope you've got an answer that will match his.
Oh, I do.
And
too.
If you do, then you get the $5,000.
Oh,
that's simple.
Great.
That'd be great. So there it is. Record blank.
Player.
Record player. They like it.
The audience.
Yes, you may indeed turn around. Okay, she says record player will match it for $5,000.
I'm so embarrassed because that was so good. I thought of record company and record breaker, and I said record album and record player.
Record album is good. Record player is good, too. There are two good ones there.
The same
that's right, you're in the same ballpark.
I'm sorry.
I'm thrilled. Don't
But you do forgive him.
Oh, I love him.
Go over and give him a little kiss and tell him here. Good. Now, wait a minute. Always a bridesmaid and never a bride. Okay, Fran, you got your $600. Let's bring out another player now. Welcome, Hal Hatfield. Ready, Fran? Okay. All right. Final Lord, Hal, you know, Fran. We welcome you, sir, and we want to find out a little bit about you.
Well, I was raised in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
The past 4 years, I was living in North Dakota,
mm-hmm.
where I met my wife. We've been married a little less than a year. We're now back out here, and I'm a pilot.
You're a pilot?
Yes.
Instrument rated and all that?
All that. Yeah. Got them all.
You fly commercially?
Yes, I do. And we're
yeah.
Yeah.
And you have blue eyes. Boy, does he have blue eyes. Home, I think I'm in love with you, Hal. But you know, it's show business. You know how show
That's
business
right.
folk are. Well, listen, Hal, good luck to you. We can't start playing now, but we will later. First, this message. Well, I'm sorry, we don't have time to do another question here or the opening round question, but we will. That'll be the first order of business when we get together next time. And we'll look forward to seeing you as we will look forward to seeing each and every one of you. I didn't say MASH, did I?
Did you?
No, I didn't say it. It's a big hit CBS show, and it's just marvelous. And indeed. This gal is just great in it, isn't
Thank
she?
You.
MASH.
Perfect.
And we hope you'll join us next time here for Match Game 76. My name is Gene Rayburn. Thank you very much. Goodbye.